Hey, my name is John Griffith. I am a software engineer at SolidFire, and I'm also currently the technical lead for the block storage project in OpenStack. Today I wanted to just go through and do a quick example and show you how easy it is to configure your OpenStack Cinder install to use SolidFire as the backend block storage. So what we have is we've already installed our OpenStack cluster and set everything up on the network. And we've also gone ahead and installed the Grizzly version of OpenStack and configured everything with the defaults and set that up. So now at this point, all we need to do is configure Cinder to use the built-in SolidFire driver that's shipped with OpenStack. So the first step is to go over to the SolidFire management interface and create a special cluster admin for OpenStack to use. So we just go here and we'll select OpenStack as the username, OpenStack as the password, and all we need is reporting, volume, and accounts access. So we'll go ahead and select those three. So there we have our OpenStack admin account created and ready to go. And then we want to get one piece of information here, and that is this management virtual IP. This is the IP address that accepts all of the API requests. So we'll go ahead and copy that. Now, let's go ahead and open a terminal and we'll SSH over to our Cinder node. All we have to do on our Cinder node is configure the etc cinder cinder.conf file point to the SolidFire driver. So I'll just create a SolidFire section here. So for the first step is just to tell it where the driver is, what driver we want it to use. Case. And then we need a SAN login, which is that special account we just created, and password. And the IP address to accept our API calls. And that's it. Those four lines are the only things that you need to add to the configuration file. Save that. Do a restart of the Cinder volume service. And so now Cinder is configured to use the SolidFire backend as its primary volume driver. So we can do a quick look here. Let's create a 20 gig volume. There we go. And just to verify, we'll go back to our SolidFire cluster, and there's our volume ready to go. And of course, we can delete it just as well. And we'll go back here. And sure enough. So that's it. You can see that configuring the SolidFire cluster to work with OpenStack is extremely easy. Four lines in the conf file. We'll have further videos that talk about how to do multi-backends, how to actually manage QoS, and how to do boot from volume and some other things like that. In the meantime, I hope that this was helpful and gives you an idea of how simple things are. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact us here at SolidFire. Thanks.